want to speak to you today.
Y quiero hablarle a usted.
Under the theme.
Bajo el tema.
No more substitutes.
No hay más sustitutos.
No more substitutes.
No hay más sustitutos.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 8, verse 6.
En el libro de Hebreos, capítulo 8, verso 6.
And I'm going to be using the Life translation.
Estoy usando la Biblia de vida.
And it says, saying, but Christ has a more perfect work. Just listen. He is the one who goes between God and man in this new and better way. The new way of worship that promises better things. This is the new way of worship, says the Lord, that I will give you. When that day comes, says the Lord, I will put my laws into their minds, speaking about his people, and I will write them in their hearts, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. Hallelujah. Amen. And the book of Hebrews is a beautiful and it is a profound book.
El libro de Hebreos es bello y muy profundo.
There have been long debates on who authored this book, who wrote this book.
Hay mucho debate de quién fue el autor.
And I am from the school that believes that it was written by Paul.
Y ella cree que como la mayoría que fue escrito por el apóstol Pablo.
And it is believed to have been written.
Y se dice que fue escrito.
In the year 70.
En el año 70.
Before the destruction of Israel.
Y antes de la destrucción de Israel.
And one of the reasons why it was written, this book, pay close attention to this.
Y oiga muy bien por la razón, en una de las razones que fue escrito.
It was because God wanted to prepare the Hebrew nation.
Porque yo quería preparar la nación hebrea.
Because pretty soon Jerusalem was about to be totally destroyed and erased from the earth.
Porque muy pronto Jerusalén iba a ser completamente destruida.
You see what was going on and pay close attention, please.
Oiga, lo que estaba sucediendo.
The Christian and Jewish people
los cristianos hebreos
that had received Jesus as their Savior
que habían recibido a Cristo como Salvador
were still living in a life
estaban todavía viviendo cierta vida
where they were very zealous, very jealous
donde eran muy celosos
for the temple,
por el templo
the sacrifices,
los sacrificios
all the rites,
todos los ritos
and they were thinking,
y estaban pensando
and they were wishing in their hearts and in their minds
y tenían una esperanza en su mente corazón,
that their beloved city Jerusalem,
que su amada ciudad Jerusalén,
under the reign and the kingdom of the Messiah,
bajo el reino del Mesías,
was going to turn into the capital of the world.
Iba a traducir, a hacerse la capital del mundo entero.
Little did they know, listen to this,
que iban a saber ellos,
that by one stroke,
que por un ataque
of the Roman army,
de lo, el ejército romano,
the holy city was going to cease from existing.
Toda la ciudad santa iba a cesar de existir.
One of the historians,
uno de los historiadores,
his name called Josephus,
se llama Josefo.
He wrote because he was during that time in Jerusalem when the destruction occurred.
Él escribía durante el tiempo que estaba sucediendo la destrucción.
And he says that when the destruction came to the city with the Roman army, that they went into the temple.
Y él dice que cuando entraron, el ejército entró a destruir todo y entraron al templo.
These soldiers were so enraged.
Estos soldados estaban tan corajientos.
And while the Jewish people would tear themselves to the temple of God and to the walls and to the altar crying because their beloved temple was going to be destroyed, they were being slaughtered there. And he writes and says,
y los hebreos aguantaban las paredes y las puertas llorando por el templo y ahí estaban siendo todos asesinados. Y este hombre escribe
that the blood was running from the altar,
que la sangre caía desde el altar,
and it would run all the way to the temple,
y caía, pues, seguía por todo el templo,
go down the stairs of that temple,
bajaba por la escalera del templo,
and was covering the streets of the city.
Y aún cubría las calles de la ciudad.
It was one of the saddest massacres ever denoted in history.
Una de las masacres más tristes que sabemos en la historia.
And what Paul was trying to warn these people before this could ever occur.
Y lo que Pablo estaba tratando de decirle antes que todo esto sucediese.
He was trying to tell them, hey guys, listen something.
Por eso mira, hombre, oigan, por favor.
What you have to understand is that the killing of those animals in the temple.
Lo que tenían que entender es que la matanza de los animales en el templo.
Could never take away any of your sins.
Esos sacrificios no podían eliminar todos los pecados.
He was trying to explain to them.
Estaba tratando de explicarle a ellos.
That those sacrifices were something that was not intended to be something perpetual.
Que esos sacrificios no eran ser eterno.
That they were just a had been a plan. Listen to this.
Era un plan.
It was a picture.
Era como un retrato, una foto.
Of the coming sacrifice of Christ, which was a perfect sacrifice.
Lo que iba a venir, que era el perfecto sacrificio de Cristo.
And Paul was trying to tell them.
Y Pablo trataba de explicarle.
Christ has already come.
Que ya Cristo vino.
He already gave his life for you.
Que ya dio su vida para usted.
All those rites and all those sacrifices you had. Have your purpose.
Todos los ritos, los sacrificios que hacían antes tenían su propósito.
But they do not exist anymore.
Pero ya no son necesarios, no existen.
Because Jesus finished the work.
Porque Jesús terminó el trabajo.
Now, why am I telling you all this?
¿Y por qué te digo todo esto?
Why am I giving you a little bit of history of why this book of Hebrews was written?
¿Por qué te doy un repaso de por qué el libro de Hebreos fue escrito?
And the word that I feel that God wants to bring into your life today.
La palabra que siento darle de parte de Dios es
that there's no need for you to be living a life with substitutes.
Que no tienes que vivir una vida con sustitutos.
When Jesus already paid the price for you to own the original.
Cuando Jesús ya pagó el precio de tú ser dueño del original.
Let me say that again.
Deja de serlo otra vez.
There's no need for you to live a life full of substitutes.
No hay necesidad de tú vivir una vida con sustitutos.
Because Jesus paid the full price for you to own.
Porque Jesús pagó el precio completo por tú tener lo original.
When we live a life of substitutes,
cuando vivimos una vida de sustitutos,
we insist on holding on to things that God has told us to let go.
Insistimos en guardar y aguantarnos de cosas que Jesús ya dijo que lo dejemos ir.
When we live a life of substitutes,
cuando vivimos una vida de sustitutos,
we try to walk forward towards the promised land.
Tratando de andar hacia adelante a la tierra prometida.
But at the same time, we continue to take little peaks that look back.
Pero seguimos a ver cuando mirando hacia atrás.
At the Egypt that he already pulled us out of.
Al Egipto que ya él lo había sacado.
Through his grace and through his mercy.
A través de su misericordia y gracia.
And the word of God for your life today is.
Y la palabra de Dios para ti en este día.
A better way.
Yo tengo una manera mejor.
1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 31.
1 Corintios 1, 12, 31.
Paul said,
y Pablo escribe diciendo,
now I will show you a better way.
Ahora te enseñaré una manera mejor.
And then he goes on to chapter 13.
Y en el capítulo 13.
And starts speaking about love.
Y empieza a hablar sobre el amor.
Dear church, today what I need for you to understand is.
Querida iglesia, hoy lo que necesito que entiendas.
The problem with substitutes is.
El problema con sustitutos es.
That no matter how hard you try, they will never be the same as the original.
Que aunque trates y trates y trates, nunca es como el original.
I mean, come on, have you ever had a tofu turkey for Thanksgiving?
Nunca ha tenido eso para Thanksgiving.
Even looking at the picture, it's kind of weird, right? It's like about something that's about to explode. It looks like a bomb ball.
Tú ves esa foto de esa comida y es rara, parece que va a explotar.
With all due respect to vegetarians.
A todos que son vegetarianos.
That's a combination of being a vegetarian and a veterinarian. You see, the problem, listen to me, with a substitute.
Pero el problema con un sustituto.
The more that you use it, listen to
lo
me.
Lo más a menudo que lo uses.
The more you end up accepting it as if it were an original.
Más lo vas a aceptar como si fuese un original.
And another danger is.
Y la otra, el otro peligro es.
That when the original and the real deal is presented to you.
Cuando lo original está presentado a usted.
You can't handle it.
No lo puedes tener.
You see it as an excessive.
¿Tú crees que es excesivo?
You see it as an exaggeration.
Como es exagerado.
Because you don't understand the pureness of it.
Porque no he entendido la pureza del original.
Let me give you an example.
Les he dado un ejemplo.
Has it ever been hard for you to understand the love of God?
¿Ha sido difícil para usted entender el amor de Dios?
And you always feel like you're failing him.
Es como que siempre le estamos fallando.
And the question is, why is this?
Y la pregunta es, ¿por qué es esto?
Because we tend to substitute the grace and the mercy of God for what you can do with your own strength and efforts.
Porque queremos reemplazar la gracia y la fuerza de Dios con nuestros propios esfuerzos.
And then we end up getting it all wrong. Listen to this.
Y entonces todo sale mal.
When I know and I understand how much God loves me.
Cuando yo entiendo y conozco cuánto Dios me ama.
And when I start seeing myself the way that God sees me.
Y cuando empiezo a ver a Dios como, a verme a mí como Dios me ve.
Not the way that other people see me.
No como otros me ven.
Not with the conditional love that human beings tend to give us.
No es con el amor condicional que otros seres nos dan.
Understanding His love.
Entendiendo su amor.
It will
automáticamente
cause a drive in me,
va a causar algo dentro de mí,
to do what I know pleases him,
hacer las cosas que yo sé le agradan a él,
to live a life that he is worthy of,
para vivir una vida que él se merece que yo viva,
and it doesn't turn into a burden, a rule, a right or a sacrifice.
Entonces no es una carga, un sacrificio o un rito.
It turns into an act of love.
Es un acto de puro amor.
When have you ever seen a newlywed?
¿Cuándo tú has visto un recién casado?
Let's approach Andrew.
Vamos a hablar a Andrew hoy.
How can we expect?
¿Cómo podemos esperar?
To approach Andrew and congratulate him for getting married.
A venir y felicitarlo por casarse.
And he's gonna say.
Y él va a decir.
Yeah. Now I gotta love her.
No, ahora la tengo que amar.
Did you believe I have to have sex with her?
¿Tú puedes creer que tengo que tener relaciones con ella?
Because when it is about pure love, listen to me.
Es de puro amor,
you understand that you're not doing anything out of service or out of dedication. Because burden, the burden factor is taken out of that.
Tú entiendes que no lo estás haciendo a través de sacrificio y por necesidad, porque esa carga es sacada.
In other words, it is turned into an act of selfless giving and pure abandonment.
Se convierte en un acto de puro abandono.
Okay, so we're talking about substitutes. Let me wrap this up.
Estamos hablando de sustitutos.
When you get used to the substitute,
cuando lo acostumbramos a los sustitutos,
and you are presented with the original,
y es presentado con lo original,
you think it's excessive.
Tú piensas que es excesivo.
God can't love me that much.
Dios no me puede amar tanto.
He can't accept me the way I am.
Él no me puede aceptar como
he
soy.
He can't see me the way that the Bible says he sees me.
Él no me puede ver como la Biblia dice que me puede ver.
Because we're substituting,
porque estamos sustituyendo,
his immeasurable love,
su amor que no se puede medir,
with what we are able to give him and offer him,
con lo que nosotros le podemos dar y ofrecer.
The Hebrew people, listen,
la gente hebrea,
couldn't understand,
no entendía,
that from offering these yearly sacrifices,
están dando sus sacrificios anuales,
where they would constantly wash their hands and the utensils in the temple,
donde siempre limpiaban las manos y los utensilios en el templo,
where they lived with rites and protocols,
donde tenía su rito y protocolo,
they couldn't understand how was it that God had a better way.
No podían entender cómo Dios podrá tener una manera mejor.
And Paul was telling them,
y Pablo le decía,
Jesus is one perfect sacrifice.
Jesús es el sacrificio perfecto.
Not only was he perfect,
no solo que él era perfecto,
he willingly gave his life for you and me.
Él voluntariamente dio su vida por usted y por mí.
Because none of those animals that were sacrificed,
porque ninguno de los animales sacrificados,
went saying, I want to be killed. None of that thing.
Ninguno fue voluntariamente.
But Jesus, the Bible says, gave his life.
Pero la Biblia dice que Jesús dio su vida.
And gave the capacity to cleanse them and forgive their sins forever.
Tenía la capacidad para limpiarlos y perdonar sus pecados para siempre.
They did not have to be reminded constantly of the sin they had committed in the past.
Ya no tienen que estar recordándose siempre del pecado del pasado.
Paul, speaking to the Hebrew people in chapter 10, verse 3, told them.
Pablo dice en el capítulo 10, versículo 3.
He said, when they gave the sacrifices year after year, it made them remember that they still had their sins.
Que cuando ellos daban su sacrificio año tras año, le hacía acordarle de sus pecados.
So every year they had to go back to remember, to bring to their mind, remembering how lost they were without God.
Y todos los años se acordaban lo perdidos que estaban sin Dios.
Paul says,
Pablo declara,
and the word is trying to teach us,
la palabra nos está tratando de enseñar,
substitutes were not made to be permanent.
Que sustitutos no fueron hechos para ser permanentes.
They are only temporary.
Son
listen,
temporeros. Oiga,
to
bien.
Replace something better that God has for the life, for your life.
Reemplazar algo mejor que Dios tiene para tu vida.
And I am here to tell you today.
Y mire hoy para decirte
that
hoy.
The time of the manifestation of the original of God.
Que el tiempo de la manifestación de lo original de Dios.
Has arrived to this place and for your life.
Ha llegado a este lugar y para tu vida.
We are constantly battling every day of our lives with substitutes.
Estamos siempre batallando con sustitutos todos los días de nuestra vida.
We substitute the love of God for the love of people.
Sustituimos el amor de Dios por el amor de personas.
The joy of the Lord.
El amor de Dios, el gozo de Dios.
We substitute it for temporary thrills.
Tratamos de sustituirlo por gozos temporeros.
We substitute it for emotions that are constantly fluctuating and changing.
Por emociones que cambian y fluctúan.
And we try to substitute the joy of the Lord for material things.
Tratamos de cambiar el amor del Señor, el gozo del Señor por cosas temporeras.
We substitute a relationship with God.
Tratamos de sustituir con la relación de Dios.
With religion.
Con religión.
Why do we substitute the love of God and the service of God with religion?
¿Por qué sustituimos el amor de Dios con religión?
Because it is the easy way out.
Porque es la manera más fácil.
Because when you are a religious person,
porque cuando eres un religioso,
you don't have to seek God.
No tienes que buscar a Dios.
You don't have to pray.
No tienes que orar.
You don't have to take time out to meditate on His word.
No tienes que coger tiempo y meditar en su palabra.
You don't have His word.
No tienes que leer su palabra.
All you have to do,
lo único que tienes que hacer,
according to the religious heart,
de acuerdo al corazón religioso,
is show up to church,
es aparecer a la iglesia,
Sunday,
a los domingos,
Thanksgiving,
en día acción de gracias,
Christmas,
Navidad,
when my kid is about to die,
cuando mi niño se está muriendo,
when my spouse is sick,
cuando mi esposo está enfermo,
okay, because that's the life of the person who lives a life of substitute.
Porque esa es la persona viviendo una vida con sustitutos.
It is a life that doesn't require compromise.
Es una vida que no requiere compromiso.
But the person who knows what it is to live the original life in God.
La persona que decide cómo vivir la vida original de Dios.
Learns how to seek His face.
Aprende cómo buscarlo.
Learns how to hear His voice.
Aprende a oír su voz.
Okay? And waits for the response of God.
Y espera la respuesta de Dios.
And lives a life that is led by the Spirit.
Y es una vida dirigida por el Espíritu de Dios.
Not a life that is led by what the world says.
No una vida dirigida por lo de acuerdo al mundo.
And I remember someone who told me.
Y me acuerdo una vez alguien me dijo.
Flor.
Me dijo Flor.
You don't have to judge things by saying if they're good or bad.
No hay que juzgar las cosas por decir si son buenas o malas.
You know, it's not good, it's not bad, it's just different.
No es bueno, no es malo, es diferente.
The easy way out.
Una manera fácil.
People who live with substitutes don't like confrontation.
Gente que vive con sustitutos no le gusta la confrontación.
Because it is a life of status quo.
Porque es una vida de status quo.
Their life is, if it's not broken, why fix it?
La vida es, si no está roto, ¿para qué arreglarlo?
But the life of a person who lives in the original of God.
Pero la vida de una persona que vive lo original de Dios.
Seeks the word of God.
Busca la palabra de Dios.
Seeks to live the life that the word of God teaches.
Busca la vida que la palabra de Dios indica.
And is willing to submit your flesh and your spirit to the Holy Spirit of God.
Y está dispuesto de someter su carne y su espíritu al Espíritu de Dios.
Knowing that it will probably
entendiendo que va a requerir sacrificio.
Knowing that it may require for you to say to many people, sorry baby, I will serve God.
Que tú vas a tener que decirle a mucha gente, perdona, pero yo voy a servirle a Dios.
But that's the life of the original in God.
Esa es la vida de un original en Dios.
Substitutes may come to our life because of poor decisions.
Sustitutos pueden venir a nuestra vida por malas decisiones.
Sometimes we substitute the original of God because we did not wait for the time of God.
A veces hacemos sustitutos porque no esperamos el tiempo de Dios.
And we commit the mistake of trying to make decisions in trying to help God bring to pass what He promised.
Y entonces somos lejos de tratar de forzar a Dios a traer a nosotros lo que Él había prometido en, okay, en el pasado.
That's exactly what Sarah did.
Eso es lo mismo que hizo Sara.
She got a word from God.
Ella recibió una palabra de
you
Dios.
Are in old age.
Tú estás anciana.
But you're going to conceive a child.
Pero vas a tener un niño.
And she got desperate.
Y
se desesperó.
Desesperó.
She did not wait for the time and the original of God.
No esperó por el tiempo y de Dios.
El original de Dios. And it says that she went running to look for a substitute.
Y ella salió a buscar una sustituta.
And gave her servant slave.
Y su sierva se la entregó.
To her husband.
A su esposo.
God said he was going to give me a child.
Dios dijo, me va a dar un niño.
Lay down with her and give me that child.
Cuéntate con ella y dame ese niño a través de ella.
Substitutes end up creating situations.
Sustitutos empiezan a dar situaciones.
That not only are going to hurt you.
Cosas que te van a doler.
But they're going to hurt others.
Que pueden doler a otros.
And the consequences will follow us during the rest of our lives.
Y las consecuencias nos persiguen el resto de nuestra vida.
The life that we live in.
La vida que vivimos.
Is constantly offering us substitutes.
Siempre está ofreciéndonos sustitutos.
And if we think about it on the top of our heads of a substitute.
Y cuando pensamos en nuestra cabeza rápido del sustituto.
One big substitute is fear.
Uno de los sustitutos grandes es temor.
And it's manifested in so many ways.
Y manifestado en tantas maneras.
If I give,
si doy,
I will lack.
Me va a hacer falta.
So let me hold on.
Me deja aguantar.
If I love unconditionally,
si amo sin condición,
I will be hurt again.
Me van a romper el corazón.
So let me hold back.
Me deja aguantar eso.
If I am friendly,
si soy amistoso,
I will be taken advantage of.
Me van a coger de bobo.
So I close myself in a shell.
Pues me cierro y me pongo me escondo.
If I let go of what God is telling me to let go.
Si dejo oír lo que el Espíritu Santo me está diciendo que tengo que dejar,
what will I be left with?
¿Con cuál es mi esperanza? ¿Con qué me quedo?
If she or he leaves me, who shall love me?
Si él o ella me dejan, ¿quién me amará?
Will I ever find anyone else who will ever love me?
¿Podré encontrar a alguien que me ame otra vez?
It is a life of substitutes.
Es una vida de sustitutos.
The life in God is a life of faith.
La vida en Dios es una vida de fe.
I can guarantee you that if God asks you to do something,
yo te puedo garantizar que si te pido que hagas algo,
and you can take it to the light of the scriptures,
si te llevo a la luz de las escrituras,
and you can back up what the word that you got from God is backed up by the word of God.
Y si la palabra que has recibido de Dios es respaldada por la palabra de Dios,
you do not have to fear.
No tienes que temer.
God has failed anyone.
Dios nunca la ha fallado a nadie.
He is not about to fail you.
Y él no te va a fallar a ti.
God has always been the perfect provider.
Siempre ha sido el perfecto proveedor.
God has always been the perfect companion.
Siempre ha sido el perfecto compañero.
He is the lover of your soul.
Él es el amante de tu alma.
He is the lover of your heart.
El amante de tu corazón.
He gave his life for you.
Él dio su vida por ti.
And all these things may appear basic.
Y todas estas cosas aparentemente son básicas.
But they are the fundament.
Pero son el fundamento
of what we believe.
De lo que nosotros creemos.
But he who paid the price.
Pero él que pagó el precio.
So that you and I could own the original.
Para que tú y yo tengamos lo original.
Says.
Dice.
Malachi 3, chapter 10.
En Malaquías 3:10.
Test me.
Probarme a mí.
Test me.
Probarme a mí.
God is telling you today, I am inviting you to test me.
Dios mío, declara, te está diciendo, probarme a mí.
It is a challenge that God gives us through his word. Test me.
Es un reto que nos dice a través de la palabra. Probarme.
I dare you to test me.
Atrévete a probarme a mí, dice
he
Dios.
Says, test me, says the Lord of all.
Dice el Dios de todo.
See if I will not open the windows of heaven.
A ver si no abriré las ventanas del cielo.
And I will pour out a good thing onto your life.
Y derramaré algo precioso en tu vida.
And you will never need anything else.
Y nunca estaré en escasez.
In the book of Proverbs, chapter 3.
En el libro de Proverbios, capítulo 3.
Verses 5 through 6.
5 al 6 nos dice.
Says, trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Confiar en el Señor con todo tu corazón.
Do not trust in your own understanding.
No confíe en tu propio entendimiento.
Agree with him.
Esté de acuerdo con él.
In all your ways.
En todos tus pasos.
And he's going to make your path a straight path.
Y él hará tu paso recto.
The original of God says. says.
Lo original de Dios declara.
In Philippians chapter 4 verses 6 through 7.
En Filipenses 4, 6 al 7.
Don't worry.
No te preocupes.
Don't worry.
No te preocupes.
Don't worry.
No te preocupes.
Do not. But he says, learn to pray about everything.
Aprender a orar sobre todo.
And give thanks to God.
Dándole gracias a Dios.
As you ask him for what you need.
Y así poder pedirle lo que necesitas.
The peace of God.
Y la paz de Dios.
Is much greater.
Es más grande.
Than the human mind can understand.
Que la mente humana pueda comprender.
This peace.
Esta paz.
Which is my peace.
¿Cuál es la de Dios? ¿Cuál es la paz de Dios?
Guard your heart.
Guardará tu corazón.
Through Jesus Christ.
A través de Jesucristo.
That's the original.
Es el original.
That's the original.
Es el original.
My dear brothers and sisters in God.
Mis hermanas y hermanos en Dios.
With God.
Con Dios.
You don't have to live a life of substitutes.
No hay sustitutos.
You don't have to live a life of a quality B when He has paid the price for the life of quality A.
No tiene que estar en cualidad B cuando él pagó el precio para cualidad A.
I'm a very particular person.
Yo soy muy particular.
I'm very particular when it comes to jewelry.
Yo soy muy particular con joyería y ropa y zapatos. La casa y
mi
marido.
and I went once through a sad experience.
Y pasé por algo triste.
I had this beautiful ruby diamond bracelet.
Y tenía un diamond bracelet, ¿cómo es eso?
Una pulsera de diamantes y rubíes. Beautiful.
De rubíes.
It cost me a lot of money.
Me costó bastante.
And when I moved to this house that I'm living at now.
Y cuando nos mudamos a la casa que tenemos ahora.
The movers stole it.
Los mudaceros se la jugaron, desapareció.
And a whole bunch of other jewelry.
Y otras joyas más.
And my husband trying to be a loving husband.
Y mi marido tratando de ser lo que un marido debe de hacer, by the way. A loving husband.
He went to K Jewelers, I think.
Fui a una joyería.
And he got me a ruby bracelet.
Y le compré un brazalete rubí que se parecía bastante al otro.
And when I opened it,
y cuando lo vi,
I said, those are not rubies.
Yo dije, esos no son rubies.
Those are lab created things.
Y son hechos en la factoría.
And I started crying.
Y empezó a llorar.
And he left the house very bad, very bad, very bad.
Y yo me fui.
Because he thought I was very ungrateful.
Pensando que no era agradecida.
And I said, those are not original.
Yo decía, es que no son originales.
I lost the original.
Yo había perdido, me robaron.
I want my original back.
Yo quiero los originales. Los
you ain't getting it from me. You ain't getting it from me because I can't afford it now.
Yo dije, bueno, de mí no sale por ahora, por eso está caro.
That's what God wants you to do.
Pero eso es lo que Dios quiere que hagas.
He wants you not to settle for seconds.
No quiere que te conforme con segundo plato.
He doesn't want you to have a good Christian life.
Él no quiere que tengas una vida buena cristiana.
He wants you to have an awesome Christian life.
Él quiere que tengas una tremenda vida en Cristo.
He doesn't want you to know him as only the saving God.
Él no solamente quiere que lo conozca como tu Salvador.
He wants you to know him as the miracle maker.
Él quiere que lo conozca como el hombre de milagros.
Supernatural.
El hombre de lo sobrenatural.
The man that if you say mountain move, he will shake that mountain. However he is, he has to shake it.
El hombre que pueda mover montañas si tú lo declaras.
Because he is the God of the original.
Porque él es el hombre de lo original.
The book of Hebrews.
En el libro de Hebreos.
Speaks about three things.
Habla de tres cosas.
Finality.
Finalizar.
Reality.
Realidad
and maturity.
Y maduramiento.
Amen. Finalidad, realidad y madurez.
Yes.
In the Jewish temple.
En el templo hebreo.
There were no chairs.
No habían sillas.
You couldn't find a chair anywhere.
No había una silla en ningún lugar.
Because the priest was constantly going in every year to offer sacrifice.
el sacerdote entraba año tras año haciendo sacrificios.
And his work was never finished.
Pero su trabajo nunca terminaba.
But the Bible says,
pero la Biblia dice,
that when the original came,
que cuando el original vino,
and took away the substitute,
y sacó todos los sustitutos,
it says that Jesus sacrificed himself on the cross,
que Jesús se sacrificó en una cruz,
ascended to heaven,
ascendió al cielo,
and he sat in his throne, listen,
y hoy está sentado, se sentó en el trono,
at the right hand of his father,
a la mano derecha de su padre.
It says that he sat,
la Biblia dice que se sentó,
because what he was trying to say,
porque lo que está tratando de decir,
the job that I just did on the cross,
el trabajo que yo he hecho en la cruz,
is the original,
es el original,
it's complete,
es completo.
No one has to offer any more sacrifices.
Nadie más tiene que hacer sacrificio. Lo que hay que hacerlo, yo lo hice.
It speaks about finality.
Habla del final.
Hebrews speaks about reality.
Hebreos hablaba de la realidad.
The work in the temple.
El trabajo en el templo.
Was all about copies and shadows.
Era todo ejemplos y tipos.
Y sombras, tipos y sombras y ejemplos. And one day someone was texting me.
Y un día me texteaba alguien.
And this person texted me back and said,
y me testió y me dijo,
God doesn't like to live in shadows.
Que Dios no le gusta estar en las sombras.
Shadows are equal to darkness.
La sombra es igual que oscuridad.
And everything that you hide sooner or later will come to light.
Y todo que se esconde tarde o temprano saldrá a luz.
And the Bible teaches us.
Y la Biblia enseña.
That while those priests were ministering on earth with the human rites,
que cuando los sacerdotes ministraban estos ritos,
con estos ritos humanos, right? It says that when the original came,
que cuando el original llegó,
he, Christ, started ministering, listen,
Cristo hoy empezó a ministrar,
from the heavens,
desde el cielo,
where all the things here on earth were copied from,
donde todas las cosas aquí en la tierra son copiadas de ella.
When you trust in Christ, listen to me.
Cuando confías en Cristo,
your life turns into a reality.
Tu vida se convierte en una realidad.
And you are forever finished with substitutes.
Y estás para siempre, terminas con los sustitutos.
The book of Hebrews speaks about maturity.
El libro de Hebreos habla de madurez.
The law of Moses,
la ley de Moisés,
was given to people just as a tutor.
Fueron dado a la gente como un tutor.
To help them grow.
Para ayudarlos a crecer.
To prepare them for the coming of the Messiah.
Para prepararlo porque Jesús venía.
They were like little children.
Eran como niñitos.
They didn't know right from wrong.
Que no sabían bien o mal.
Rules had to be set.
Pues se pusieron reglas.
And the work in the temple.
Y el trabajo en el templo.
Were all substitutes.
Eran sustitutos.
To help them grow.
Para ayudarlos a crecer.
And God had to take them by the hand like little children.
Dios los tenía que coger por la mano como niños pequeños.
But now.
Pero ahora.
Up to the original.
Cuando estamos en el original.
God began to do what he always wanted to do with his people.
Dios empezó a hacer lo que siempre ha querido hacer con su gente.
And that's where the verse that we read at the beginning comes in.
Y ahí es donde podemos ver el versículo que empezamos.
And that we see it again in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 16.
Y lo vemos otra vez en Hebreos 10, 16.
The original.
Lo original.
What God always wanted. What God always wanted.
Dios siempre quiso.
For his children.
Para sus niños.
Para sus hijos, was to lead them,
para dirigirlos,
to a spiritual maturity in God,
para una madurez espiritual en Dios,
where his law,
donde su ley,
you don't have to have it written,
no tiene que ser escrita,
on a piece of paper,
en un papel,
where somebody doesn't have to be correcting you constantly,
donde alguien siempre te tiene que corregir,
where somebody has to constantly be watching over you,
donde alguien siempre te tiene que estar velando,
because those that have to be watched are little children.
Porque eso que siempre tienen que estar velándonos son niños pequeños.
Paul cried out many times in his heart.
Pablo lloraba muchas veces en su corazón.
And he would say, how long will I have to continue to feed you formula, spiritual milk?
Y le decía a los cristianos, ¿hasta cuánto tiempo tendrá yo que darte
leche espiritual? Cosas de niño.
Things of children.
But he says, well, you should be at a level where you are able to eat meat.
Ya tú debes estar a un nivel de que debes estar comiendo sólido carne.
And then the original,
y el original
brings you to maturity,
te trae a la madurez,
where now you don't have to be guided as a little child,
ya no necesitas ser guiado constante como un niño,
where you don't constantly have to be reminded what to do or not what to do,
no hay que estarse recordando de qué debes de hacer, qué no debes de hacer,
because in Hebrews chapter 10 verse 16 it says,
10:16 nos dice,
this is the new way of worship,
esta es la nueva manera de adorar,
that I will give to them,
que te daré a ustedes,
when the day comes, says
cuando
the
día
Lord,
viene, dice Dios,
I will put my laws,
pondré mi ley,
in their hearts,
en su corazón,
and I will put it in their minds,
y se la escribiré en sus mentes,
and they shall never forget them,
y nunca se lo olvidará.
The Hebrew people had a custom.
Los hebreos tenían una costumbre.
And they still do it.
Y todavía lo hacen.
If you enter the house of a practicing Jewish person,
si entra una casa de alguien que practica hebreo,
la religión hebrea practicante, they always write around the doors, the frame of the doors, the commandments and the word, because it was said, write them constantly so that your children see them.
En la puerta ponen las leyes de Moisés para que sus hijos las vean y las lean.
But the Lord said, I have a better way.
Pero hebreo dice que yo tengo una manera mejor.
I have an original way.
Yo tengo una manera original.
I don't want you to live with substitutes anymore.
Yo no quiero que viva más con sustitutos.
I don't want you to be living like a second class citizen.
Yo no quiero que viva como un ciudadano segunda clase.
When you live in the original,
cuando vives en el original,
you see yourself as a woman of God.
Tú te ves como una mujer de Dios.
You see yourself as a man of God.
Te ves como un hombre de Dios.
You see yourself as an ambassador of the kingdom of God upon this heaven.
Te ves como un embajador del reino del Señor aquí.
And when people fight you,
y cuando pelean contigo,
you don't fight back.
Tú no tienes que pelear
because
para
they're
atrás.
Not messing with you.
Porque no están fastidiándote a ti.
They're messing with your father.
Están fastidiando al padre.
And he's gonna fight for
y
you.
Y él peleará por ti.
That's the life of the original.
Esa es la vida del original.
Don't settle for second best.
No te conformas con segundo paso.
Shoot for the stars.
Tírate a las estrellas.
That's what God told Abraham. Your descendants will be like the stars. So the beginning of that phrase, shoot for the stars, was given to Jehovah, to Abraham, when he said your descendants will be like the amount of stars in the skies, if you can count them.
Hay que pensar como las estrellas, como Dios le habló a Abraham, que mira las estrellas, así será su descendencia.
Don't settle for less.
No te
conformes
con menos.
Substituyendo what you have,
lo que tienes,
and not expecting to receive what God has already purchased for you.
Y no en espera de lo que Dios ya ha comprado para ti.
God bless you.
God bless.
God bless.
Dios bendiga.
Stand to your feet.
Vamos a estar en pie.
Hallelujah. Do you receive that word?
¿Tú recibes esa palabra?
Do you receive that word?
¿Recibes esa palabra?
Can you apply that to every area of your life?
¿Podrás aplicar eso a todas las partes de tu vida?
Those that are single.
Esos que son solteros.
Are you willing to wait for the man of God that God wants for your life?
¿Estás dispuesto a esperar al hombre de Dios que tenga para ti?
Are you willing to receive the woman of God that God has for your life?
¿Estás dispuesto a esperar para la mujer de Dios que tiene para
woman,
tu vida? Sabe esperar en Dios.
Are you willing to let God do His job?
¿Estás dispuesto a dejar Dios hacer su trabajo?
While you kindly obey Him.
Lo que tú lo obedeces.
Don't disappear on God.
No desaparezca en Dios.
By staying in your house.
Estando quedándose en la casa.
Not congregating.
No congregándote.
Not reading His word.
No leyendo la palabra.
Not seeking His face.
No buscando uno a uno.
God has come to give you the original.
Dios ha venido para darte lo original.
You've tried it many ways, different ways, many times.
Tú lo trataste muchas maneras, diferentes tiempos.
With partners.
Con compañeros.
That have failed you.
Que te han fallado.
People that have abused your trust.
Gente que ha abusado tu confianza.
God is telling you today.
Dios te dice hoy.
Try it my way.
Trátalo de mi manera.
Try it my way.
Trátalo de mi manera.
I have. Yo. And I have always had.
Tengo y siempre tendré.
The plan.
El plan.
For your life.
Para tu vida.
Has been established in heaven.
Está ya establecida en el cielo.
And I present it to you today.
Y te lo puedo mandar a ti hoy.
People, everything has been written.
ha sido escrito.
When you were created, everything was written.
Cuando fuiste creado, ya estaba todo escrito sobre ti.
He knew the potential you have.
Él sabía el potencial que tienes.
He knew what you're capable of doing and being.
Él sabe la capacidad que tiene para lograr.
And you and I probably took a different route.
Quizás cogimos otra ruta.
And you and I probably did many mistakes.
Hicimos muchos errores, tú y yo.
But here we are today.
Pero estamos aquí hoy.
And he says, won't you give me a chance?
Y él dice, dame la oportunidad.
Give me a chance.
Dame la oportunidad.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We honor you, Jesus. We praise you and we exalt your holy name, Father God. We thank you because we do not have to live with substitutes.
Yes.
When we come before your presence and we receive you, Father. The end of shadows and of copies has arrived. And you bring us to a life of reality, a life of clearness, a life where the veil has been ripped in half and we don't need nobody else to intercede for us before your presence. You say, come, come confidently to me. And I will hear your voice and hear your cry and I will answer your prayers. Father God,
thank you, Jesus.
Praise God, thank you.
Help us to see, Father God,
thank you, Holy Spirit.
Because you are the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to the Father, no one can fulfill their destiny unless it is with you. The world screams a lot of voices, the world tells us a lot of things. Oh, how many things, so many substitutes, so many substitutes. Hallelujah. Whispers constant substitutes into our ears. How can it be possible that there's only one way? How can it be possible that there's only one God? And how can it be possible that there's a hell? And how can it be possible that there's a heaven?
Hallelujah.
Open our eyes to see the spirit world. Open our heart to hear your voice above all those mumbling voices. Understand, Father God, that you have always desired for all the best in request. Thank you for your church. Thank you for your people. Thank you for this time. Thank you for this hour. I declare a blessing upon each and every one of our lives. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth. I declare in the name of Jesus,
declaramos en el nombre de Jesús,
that a certain type of itchiness, something that's going to make us feel uncomfortable, Father God, until we reach what you want us to reach, that we don't remain status quo, Father God,
no nos conformemos status quo.
To not be conformed to this world, like Paul said, but to renew our minds.
Sino renovar nuestras mentes.